Now, this is what we've done since last time. Now we live in Siberia and a city called New Krasnoyarsk. Now we'll be doing a little bit more touring later, but this is essentially all you need to know. I'm gonna fly over to where we were last time, just to give you a sense of distance, but it's not gonna load in. In fact, it's gonna kick me since the server is really laggy right now, and honestly, it was a little bit funny. Now it's time to actually take a good look at New Krasnoyarsk. Now, there's a lot of stuff going on here, but it's based off of the Russian city of, obviously, Krasnoyarsk. So, there's an Among Us, and we have a tank, but the tank wasn't really loading in. Because, funny. So then, right about here, it actually loaded, and you can see a pretty nice view of New Krasnoyarsk and everything in it. So there's the tank in the middle and Fred. Fred is essentially worshipped in New Krasnoyarsk, but that one's actually freed. Fred somehow perished. This is the, like, office. I have no idea how to get in or what's really in there. I don't know if I should be in there. That's the community storage. That's the hut of a new member, right? You know, just really simple stuff like that. There's a freeway system and a sugarcane farm. It's actually pretty sophisticated. We also have some apartments like this way, like this. And then we have a train system station thing, the Great Siberian Railway, which apparently just goes into nothingness. I don't know. It was really weird. But that's about all for the stuff in actually in New Krasnoyarsk. So there's also some other nations, as I mentioned. So if you take a minor road to this border crossing here, this enters Quebec. So I probably shouldn't cross here and look at stuff in case they have any secret things going on. After all, we are at war. But in here is Quebec. So that's cool. There's also another nation called Hawkland. And then where I'm going right now is, this is Highway 5, or rather just 5. And this goes to another arch, but this isn't actually a border crossing. This is the historic border crossing of Siberia and Quebec, but no longer is, because our lands have changed from war and negotiation and all of that. As I was saying, the other nation is Hawkland, which is to the north, and that is a different thing, and I will show you that on a map shortly. There's not a lot else I can show you without traveling really far, so I think that this is going to be it, except for the map. So, what you are seeing now is a map. A giant map of the area. So, before we get into this and all this stuff, you can see most of it, and it's pretty obvious, but there's a few things to clear up. So, one, anything orange in terms of roads is built, and anything red is not. Cities are also in red, though, so I can see how that can be a bit confusing, but the cities, except for Factoryville, are built. So, there are currently 4 plots of land, 3 of which are countries. There's Hawkland in the north, Siberia in the middle, and then Quebec. Now, in the old map, Quebec actually extended further north, and blocked off and had a land border with Hawkland. This was changed to basically because we wanted to allow Siberia to expand to where old Factoryville is. So that was the whole border crossing that wasn't really a border crossing. And then there's a little plot of land around old Factoryville that's international preservation. No one can mess with that, really. So, the story of Old Factoryville is actually kind of interesting and also really stupid. So, essentially, when my friend first made the maps, he got it the wrong way around because it was pre-Quebec. So, he didn't have as many landmarks, and he got it the wrong way around. And when I made Olfactoryville, I was following that map and didn't notice that I'd gone all the way through Quebec's land and built Olfactoryville on the other side. So that was a thing. But luckily, I fixed that with the new map, and then that's going to be preservation. So no one can mess with that land anymore. So that's essentially all of that. So that was essentially everything that's happened since. It doesn't really have any recent events, like stuff with the war on Quebec or killing some friends or anything with borders or the making of the freeways. Because I haven't really been recording that stuff, but I'm hoping to get back into it. Even though this series has been really mean to me with the first episode not having audio and the second one having audio with fans and noise and all of that. But hopefully it'll get better from here. So, yeah.